What is going on, everyone? I am back with more videos as life has started to level out again, and today we are breaking down the latest live stream and talking about all the interesting updates that were shared. So let's get into it. Starting off with a few important updates on Ashes that we learned. Alpha 1 testing is still on track for this year, which is excellent news, even though I haven't doubted it for a moment with the amount of content that we have seen lately, and it's even better knowing that there are only 3 more months in the year, so it's not much longer of a wait. There is also a Halloween pumpkin carving contest going on right now. You can find out more details on the Ashes of Creation Twitter, but things will be given away such as AMD graphics cards and Alpha 1 keys. So if you don't have access to Alpha 1 and you're really good at making pumpkins, well, go enter that contest. And last, just a reminder that October 6th is the last full day for you to get your hands on the Heat and Harmony cosmetic set over on the Ashes of Creation store. So if you want this set, well, go get it, and you can even make an account using my referral link in the description below if you don't have one yet. Anyways, on to the good stuff. Jumping right into the live stream, it starts out with some mount gameplay and lots of detail on aquatic mounts. We got about 20 or so minutes of mount gameplay in this stream, which was also uploaded to YouTube as a standalone video, and there is a lot of interesting details in it that I am actually going to do a separate video on it breaking it down. But to give a quick summary, we see the devs set out into water on some aquatic mounts. These mounts, as you would expect, are pretty slow on land, but once they are fully submerged in water, they move pretty fast. These will be useful as there is loads of underwater content and naval content in Ashes of Creation for players to jump into. I'll try to get that full breakdown on that video out by Wednesday or Thursday for you guys, but if you want to check out the video in the meantime, link is in the description below. After mount, we get to look at some cool dwarven furniture that we will be seeing throughout the world in dwarven settlements. We got some chairs, beds, dressers that are shown open and closed, along with cupboards as well. And even some dwarven tables that will be just the right size for your small dwarf figure. Moving on and jumping into the world map, we get our first look at a new tropical biome through some new concept art. And as you can see, this area looks absolutely gorgeous and hopefully pretty exciting to explore. Some of these shots have a very piratey feel to it, with ships sitting in the coves of these tropical jungles, which would be really cool to explore in the game. As I've said many times before, Intrepid's art team does an amazing job bringing concept art to life, so these images should give you a real good feel of how they will play out in the world. We then get a look at the Ramstrider mount, which is another mount for Ashes of Creation that was also teased a few days earlier in the Ashes of Creation Discord. And speaking of mounts, you will be able to equip gear onto your mounts and pets, such as saddles shown here. While this one shown is just a cosmetic skin, actual saddles will have various stats such as increasing speed or mitigating incoming damage. Lastly, we got to look at some gear, showcasing us some dwarf, elf, and human armor sets. We have already seen lots of gear in previous videos, but this continues to showcase the amount of effort that is going into armor, as it is a very important and big part of the MMORPG genre, and I personally will take all of the dwarf content I can get my hands on. What are your thoughts on this quick breakdown of the September live stream? Let me know in the comments down below, and if you are new to Ashes of Creation at all and have yet to make an account over on the website, feel free to use my referral link in the description below. Otherwise, be sure to click on that subscribe button, hit that thumbs up, turn on the bell for notifications, and stay tuned for a lot more news to come.